variation of Fermi energy level and carrier concentration with temperature and impurity in p-type of semiconductor. If you see the band structure of a p-type of semiconductor at 0 Kelvin, the Fermi energy level lies exactly between the valency band and the acceptor energy level. So now when the temperature increases, the Fermi energy level slowly shifts and it approaches a maximum of EI, where EI is the intrinsic Fermi energy level region. So expression for density of holes in terms of Na, that is acceptor energy level. Substituting equation 5 in equation 1, we get the density of holes NH is equal to 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 exponential of EV minus EV plus EA by 2 minus kbt by 2 log Na divided by 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 divided by kbt. So this equation N of h, the density of holes, is given as N of h is equal to 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 exponential of 2 EV minus EV by EA by 2 kbt plus 1 by 2 log Na divided by 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2. So this equation is again simplified as N of h is equal to 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 exponential of EV minus EA divided by 2 kbt exponential log Na power 1 by 2 divided by 2 power half into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 whole power half. So here EV minus EA, so again this equation is simplified as 2A into Na power half 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 2 e power EV minus EA divided by 2 kbt. Put this as equation number 6. So from this equation, EV minus EA is known as the ionization for energy for the acceptor energy level and it is given as del E. So this is the minimum energy required for an electron to move from the hole to move from the valency band to the acceptor energy level. Therefore the density of holes is given as NH is equal to 2 into Na power 1 by 2 into 2 pi m star h kbt by h square whole power 3 by 4 e power minus del E divided by 2 kbt. Put this as equation number 7. So from this equation 7, what we can understand is the density of holes is proportional to the square root of the number of electrons in the acceptor energy level. Number of electrons in the acceptor energy level, and the Fermi energy level shifts upwards. When the temperature increases, the Fermi energy level shifts upwards and it approaches the intrinsic region. Elemental and compound semiconductors. Based on the composition, the semiconductors are classified into two different types, such as elemental semiconductors and compound semiconductors. So first let us see what are elemental semiconductors. Elemental semiconductors are the pure form of semiconductors in which the entire semiconductor is made up of a single crystal. For a good example of elemental semiconductors are germanium and silicon. So in this case what happens, otherwise these elemental semiconductors are called as indirect band gap semiconductors. Elemental semiconductors are otherwise called as indirect band gap semiconductors. So in case of indirect band gap semiconductors, the recombination of electrons in the valency band and holes in the conductional band takes place via traps. So during this recombination via traps, a phonon is emitted and heats the lattice vibration. So in case of compound semiconductors, these compound semiconductors are obtained or formed by doping the fifth and the third column elements and second and sixth column elements. A good example is gallium arsenide, indium phosphate. These are very good examples of compound semiconductors. So these compound semiconductors are otherwise called as direct band gap semiconductors. So here the recombination of electrons in the valency band and holes in the conductional band takes place directly and phonons are emitted in the visible and infrared region. Hall effect. So by measuring the conductivity, we can say that the conductivity is due to electrons are due to holes, and we cannot differentiate whether it is a p-type material or an n-type material. So to differentiate between a p-type material and n-type material, Hall effect is used. So now let us see what is Hall effect. When a conductor carrying current is placed in a transverse magnetic field, an electric field is produced normal to the current and the magnetic field. This effect is called as Hall effect, and the voltage developed is called as Hall voltage. So for example, let us consider an N type of material. N type of material, X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Now a current is applied along the X axis. And the magnetic field is applied along the Z axis. So now when an electric field is applied along the X axis from right to left, electrons will move from left to right. So now when a magnetic field is applied along the Z direction, a Hall voltage will be developed along Y direction, normal to both electric field and the magnetic field. So due to this, what happens when the electrons are moving from left to right, due to the applied magnetic field, all the electrons will start accumulating in phase 1, and this is phase 2. All the electrons, due to the application of the magnetic field, all the electrons will be accumulated in phase 1. So now due to this, what happens, a potential difference is developed between phase 1 and phase 2, and due to this a voltage is developed. This voltage is called as Hall voltage. So now let us see how Hall voltage is determined in case of N type of semiconductors. Force due to potential difference is equal to E minus E into EH. Put this as equation number 1. And force due to the magnetic field is equal to minus BE into V. So at equilibrium condition, equation 1 is equal to equation 2. That is minus EH is equal to minus BE into V. Or EH is equal to BV. Put this as equation number 3. Current density JX in the X direction is JX is equal to minus NE into EV, where V is equal to minus JX divided by NE into E. Substituting, put this as equation number 4. Substituting equation 4 in equation 3, we get EH is equal to minus BJX divided by NE into E. Put this as equation number 5, where EX is equal to RH into JX into B, where RH is known as Hall coefficient, and RH is given by RH is equal to minus 1 by NE into E. So this negative sign indicates that the Hall voltage developed is along the negative Y direction. Hall coefficient in terms of Hall voltage. If the thickness of the sample is T and the voltage developed is VH, then the Hall voltage is given as VH is equal to EH into T. Put this as equation number 1. So we all know that EH is equal to RH into JX into D, where RH is the Hall coefficient, JX is the current density, and D is the applied magnetic field. Substituting equation 1 in equation 2, we get VH is equal to RH into JX into B into T. So if B is the width of the sample, then area is equal to breadth into thickness, B into T. Therefore the current density JX is equal to IX divided by BT. So substituting the value of equation, put this as equation number 4, substituting equation 4 in equation 3, we get VH is equal to RH IX BT divided by BT, where VH is equal to this T and this T will get cancelled. Therefore VH is equal to RH into IX into B divided by B. Therefore Hall coefficient RH is equal to VHB divided by IX into B. Experimental determination of Hall effect. So to find the Hall all affect experimentally. Let us consider a semiconductor, a slab of semiconductor of thickness T and breadth D. So in this case, what happens? This is Z axis, X axis and Y axis. An electric field is applied along the X direction and the magnetic field is applied along Z direction, and the Hall voltage is measured along the Y direction. So to determine the Hall effect experimentally, let us consider a slab of semiconductor of thickness T and breadth T. Along the X direction, the electric field is applied along the X direction and the magnetic field is applied along the Z direction, and the Hall voltage is developed along the Y direction. If B is the applied magnetic field and VH is the Hall voltage, then the Hall coefficient can be calculated from the formula RH is equal to VHB divided by IX into B, where VH is the Hall coefficient, IX is the current density, B is the breadth of the sample, and B is the applied magnetic field. So from this, the mobility of charge carriers can be calculated. So in general, the Hall coefficient can be written as RH is equal to minus 1 divided by NE. The above expression is valid only for the semiconductors where the velocity is taken as drift velocity. So semiconductor velocity is taken as average velocity. So the Hall coefficient RH for N-type semiconductor is modified as RH is equal to minus 3 pi by 8 into 1 divided by NE into E, or RH is equal to minus 1.18 divided by NE into E. Put this as equation number 1. So the conductivity of an N-type semiconductor, sigma E is given as NE into E into mu E, where mu E is the mobility of charge carriers, NE is the electron density and E is the charge of the electron. So therefore the electron mobility mu E is given as sigma E divided by NE into E. Put this as equation number 2. So from equation 1 we can write 1 by N of E into E is equal to minus RH divided by 1.18. Put this as equation number 3. So substituting equation 3 in equation 2. So substituting the value of 1 by N of E in this equation, equation number 2. So therefore the mobility of charge carriers mu E is equal to minus sigma E RH divided by 1.18. So therefore the mobility of electrons in N-type semiconductor is given as mu E is equal to minus sigma E VHB divided by 1.18 into IX into B, where RH, Hall coefficient, is equal to VHB divided by IX into B. So this is the mobility charge carriers for N type of material. Suppose if it is of P type material, this negative sign will not be there. Therefore, in case of holes, it is mu H, and the negative sign will get cancelled. So therefore, the mobility of holes or the mobility of P type of semiconductor is given as sigma H VHB divided by 1.18 IX into P. Applications of Hall effect. So this Hall effect is used to determine whether the semiconducting material is a P-type semiconductor or an N-type of semiconductor. If the Hall coefficient is positive, it is P-type semiconductor, and if the Hall coefficient is negative, it is an N-type of semiconductor. And it is used to find the carrier concentration in both N-type of semiconductors and P-type of semiconductors. And it is also used to find the sign of the charge carriers or sign of the current carrying. And it is also used to find the power flow in electromagnetic waves. So these are some of the important applications of Hall effect. The main application of Hall effect is to find whether the semiconducting material is a P-type of semiconductor or an N-type of semiconductor.